Hi everyone, welcome back to XGate Dental. I'm Emmanuel Kadosh and we are here to discuss new procedures in the field of dentistry. We will provide interesting new cases to exhibit how doctors use our products to solve complicated dental cases. Don't forget to subscribe and follow us to stay up to date. So let's get started. The topic for today is going to be more directed towards the patient. We're going to be covering implantations. Now, for those who don't know, we have an external thread and an internal thread. The external thread is screwed into the bone in the jaw, and the internal thread is for the structure of the crown to hold onto the implant. In the first phase of the implantation, it's screwed under pressure, and you have some internal pressure that holds the implant. On the second stage of the implantation, after a couple of months, the bone reabsorbs and changes. So you have an osseointegration, which means that the bone grows around the implant. So it becomes something embedded in the bone, which in turn means that you can't take it out. So basically, the bone grows around and holds the implant. Many patients wonder why their doctors would even choose implantation and not, let's say, some sort of other restoration that is less intrusive. But honestly, there aren't really any less intrusive restorations because when you don't have a tooth and you want to restore the missing tooth, you have literally three options. The first option would be a removable option like a small denture. With a small denture, the biggest flaw is that it's removable. You need to take it out to clean it outside the mouth, and many people don't feel comfortable with that. So the other two options are fixed prosthetic. You can have an implant and you can have a bridge on the teeth. But if you have normal, regular teeth that don't need any procedure at all, you still need to prepare them and remove some part of the tooth to make a bridge for this, which would ultimately mean that you would need to ruin two teeth to restore one tooth. So it doesn't really make sense. Instead, you can have one implant, and this way you don't need to touch the approximate teeth. Implants have been around for over 60 years. We are well aware at this point about the prognosis of the implant. We know what kind of problems can arise. We know the drawbacks, and of course, we also know the advantages of the implantations. In most cases, having implants is going to be a better move than dentures. All of the implants are made from different types of titanium. Today, there are very few implants that are made from zirconia. Around 99.9% of the implants on the market today are made from titanium. The most interesting part about titanium is that when you insert a titanium that is sterile and clean into the bone grows around and inside the titanium. So the titanium becomes part of the bone. With different kinds of metals, you don't have this effect. You'll have a fibrosis membrane around the metal. It will be movable, but in titanium, you don't have this. The titanium is embedded into the bone. Now, when you have a missing tooth in the space between the teeth, the adjacent teeth, you place an implant and you need to wait about 3 or 4 months for the implant to heal itself in the bone. In 3 to 4 months, the bone will become one with the implant. Now, after this period of time, you can open the implant and insert all the substructures that you need to replace the crown. So you need to close the implant, then you need to open the implant, and you can place inside the implant different structures to build the future crown or the future restoration that you want to replace the missing tooth. The crown is made from ceramic, which is a fragile material. You can't screw it inside the implant because it'll break. So you need to have some part between the implant and some kind of adapter. So you have the crown, you can glue the crown into the adapter, and this adapter you can just screw into the implant. So this is what you see here. In here, what you see is called a multi-unit. This is kind of an adapter for the crown. On one side, it connects to the implant, and on the other side, it will connect to the future crown. Almost all the adapters screw to the implant, and the crowns can be either cemented or screwed to the adapters. Many people ask, when does the patient know that he even needs to have an implant and not some other procedure? There are many different types of treatments for teeth. For example, you can have a tooth filling or a root canal treatment. It's different procedures, but when the tooth is rotten, when the tooth is broken, and when it's unrestorable, your doctor will tell you that there's a problem. And in most cases, it means that we need to extract the tooth. Now, later on, you can choose to restore the space between the adjacent teeth when you have a missing tooth or leave it as is. In this case, if you want to make a bridge, you need to prepare. You need to remove material from the tooth to have a bridge. So in most cases, when the doctor recommends going for this type of procedure for the implantation, it will always be when the tooth is totally useless or essentially unrestorable. It's very important to close the implant because when you eat food, it can get inside or the gingiva can grow inside the implant. This way, the implant inside has a screw, so it can ruin the screw and you won't be able to insert anything into the implant. Now, let's give another example. Let's say someone has a lost tooth somewhere in the lower jaw, further back, or perhaps buccally. Why would we even do an implant there if it's not affecting anything even aesthetically? Well, there are complications that can occur when you have a missing tooth. For example, the tooth on the other jaw that are supposed to be adjacent to this tooth can come out and you'll have a problem in the jaw or in the function. So if you have a lost tooth on the lower jaw, it can affect the teeth on the upper jaw. The teeth need to touch each other. So when you have a missing tooth, the tooth that needs to touch this tooth can come out. So it's a problem that can occur, and it's not always the case, but it can cause complications. Now, the neighboring tooth, or the tooth after the missing tooth, can move into the frontal area where it will try to close up the gap. So in the future, when you do want to have an implant to restore that space, it will be a bit of a problem because the adjacent teeth close it a little bit. The jaw reforms by itself, so if you decide you want to restore, you need to do as quickly as possible. Now, the question is, what happens with the gingiva? Well, that's actually super interesting because when you don't have a tooth, the bone can be reabsorbed. It disappears. So if you want to have an implant in about 5 or 10 years, you might not have enough bone to place an implant because the bone and the gingiva stays the same when you have some function. When you have a piece of bone that doesn't have any teeth or isn't used in any way, it just disappears. The bone doesn't need it. So in the future, it is possible that you won't have enough bone for the implant. Now, let's say you have some teeth that are rotten or there needs to be a root canal treatment done. If you don't perform the root canal treatment and the roots are rotten, then the bone can also be absorbed. If you have an inflammation, the bone can also be absorbed. The bone can reject the tooth and it will be a very painful process. So statistically speaking, there'll be less of a chance that the procedure will go well if there's inflammation. So if you have some kind of inflammation, in most cases, you need to wait a little bit for it to resolve. Clean the area, take antibiotics, antiseptics, anything you need to resolve the inflammation, or the implant may not be healed. And maybe the body will reject the implant. Let's talk a little bit about the structure that we mentioned before and what the difference between them are. When you have an implant, in most of the cases, the doctor will choose what type of structure he prefers to have the restoration. And the doctor chooses if he wants to do it in a screw retained or cemented. Each kind of structure fits best for different types of cases. If you don't have enough bone, the doctor can place the implant in an angulated way. So if the implant is placed in an angulated way, you need to correct the angulation of the implant. In this way, you can use some kind of structure that are angulated. The structure itself has the ability to correct the angulation of the implant. When you have parallel implants, you can choose to use thread structures. When you have all of the structures inside your mouth, the doctor needs to take impressions on those structures. He needs to know the orientation and the place of those structures to be able to make a bridge or some kind of restoration on those structures. So he needs to take some kind of impression. There are lots of ways to take impressions with the silicone material that they put inside your mouth or with an intraoral scanner. There are different technologies that are suitable for different kinds of cases. So this plastic cap, what you see here, is some kind of cap that the doctor screw onto those structures and then can take the scanner and he can scan all of those structures. Let's summarize really quickly. If the doctor recommends you have an implant done, first of all, you will have it inserted to the bone. Afterwards, there's a healing process. Then a structure will be screwed to this implant, and then another structure, and above this structure, a crown. So overall, there will be 3 structures plus the crown. In most of the cases, all doctors want to see a follow-up to be sure that what they did is good and will hold, and of course, to check if there are some kind of minor complications to correct, which of course, we hope is not the case, but you never know. Thank you everyone that joined in to learn some new and interesting information. Make sure to stay tuned for more. And of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow. Thank you and see you next time.